Commissioner, good afternoon to you. Thanks for joining us today. Appreciate you coming to the program.
Yes.
All right. So Attorney Guanzon, the decision, it's finally out, voting 2-0, allowing Marcos Jr. to run. What does this decision tell you? And what does this decision tell the public?
The main rationale for Ferolino's resolution, concurred by Commissioner Casqueo, is that she said that the non-filing of income tax return by Marcos Jr. is not moral turpitude because it is not mala prohibita. Meaning that the crime is not the crime of income tax, non-filing of income tax return is a crime only because the law defines it to be a crime, as compared with mala inse, which the crime is really an offense by the nature of the gruesome acts such as rape, homicide, parricide, depravity acts such as seduction, staffa, you know. But she's wrong because in 1996 in De La Torre versus Comelec, that has already been the ruling of the Supreme Court, that it is not necessary, that it does not necessarily mean that only crimes that are mala in se are crimes involving moral turpitude. For example, also Ferolino said that there was no fraud on the part of Marcos Jr., so therefore it was not moral turpitude. There's also no fraud in rape. Is there fraud in rape? But rape is moral turpitude. There's fraud in estafa, but it is also moral turpitude. That's why in De La Torre versus Comelec in 1996, the Supreme Court ruled that it doesn't necessarily mean that only crimes that are mala in se involve moral turpitude. Golly. Big golly.
So, Commissioner,
citing an older case. And again, our other rationale is that there was no intent. How can there be no intent on the part of Marcos Jr. to evade paying of his taxes when he did not file his income tax return 4 times? And then when he was convicted, he did not even pay the fine, which shows his depravity in his moral values and conduct. That's why it's moral turpitude, repeated acts, repeated acts. That's why, well, as you know, Ferolino delayed this so that my vote will not be counted and so that my separate opinion will not be part of the records that will go up to the Supreme Court.
Attorney Guanzon, that Commissioner Ferolino relied exclusively on the elements of the offense. You said that this is wrong. Kindly explain to us why this is wrong, considering that she only exclusively relied on the elements of the offense. Attorney Guanzon.
That's why you cannot, as a judge, you should not rely on the elements of the offense to ascertain moral turpitude. The court already said that in De La Torre versus Comelec in 1996. Because the element, because if you go for the element of the offense only, you're referring only to the offenses or crimes that are mala in se, such as rape, estafa, seduction. Seduction by promise of marriage. But again, the Supreme Court already said that that list is not exclusive in De La Torre versus Comelec 1996. That it doesn't necessarily mean that only crimes that are mala in se involve moral turpitude. Crimes also that are mala prohibita are also involving moral turpitude. You have to weigh it using substantial evidence rule, which is more than enough. 4 times he did not file his ITR, did not pay the fine, and he did not even show proof, valid proof, that they paid the deficiency taxes of Marcos in the BIR. I think it's a very analysis and use of jurisprudence is wrong. And this will go up to the Supreme Court, so I'm glad. So that then it will be tested, no? But and also her resolution is, her logic is atrocious, and it's full of grammatical and typographical errors, which means that She probably did not really spend time studying it. And why did it take her 30 days to release it? Precisely that I'm saying, because she delayed it so that my vote against Marcos will not be counted.
But even if it were counted, the final voting was 2-0. Even if you were still there,
so,
it's going to be 2-1.
My dissenting opinion would be part of the records. That's how it works, all the way to the Supreme Court. The intention really is to exclude my opinion so that it will not be part of the records. But yun nga, sinasabi ko nga, kung hindi siya sinuhulan, bakit dinilay niya yan? Sino nag-utos sa kanya na i-delay niya yan hanggang makaretire ako? Oh.
So balik po tayo doon, Attorney Guanzon.
Excuse me, it doesn't sound good for the president. It doesn't, it leaves a poor taste in the mouth. Because the president already said to Sal Panelo, I heard him right, the president does not interfere in COMELEC. And some people may be using his name. And they're both from Davao, Ferolino and Casquejo, which is unfortunate. Because then people will conclude that these commissioners from Davao were colluding. But Casquejo wrote a separate opinion explaining his vote. But again, I also disagree with him.
Attorney Guanzon, let me just go back to an earlier statement that you made. You said po, kung hindi siya sinuhulan, bakit niya dinelay? So balik po tayo doon. Sino po ba ang nangsuhol? And when are you going to reveal the name?
That is the question. Kung hindi siya sinuhulan, bakit it took her 30 days to exclude me? Wala naman siyang galit sa akin personal, sabi niya. In fact, pupunta naman siya sa akin pag may kailangan siya. O may kaso siya na gusto niya i-consulta sa PSID. So that is the question that I keep on throwing at her. But it's too late now because she really delayed it. So now I said, that is really graft because she delayed it. Intentionally to favor a litigant under Section 3C of the Anti-Graft and Corrupt Practices Act.
Attorney Guanzon, you said it's too late now. The decision has been handed out. Are you still going to name names? Are you still going to reveal the next senator?
Let's focus on the resolution because that is going to the Supreme Court. I already said that. I already told Senate President Soto. Let's not go into that. Let's focus on this atrocious logic of Perolino and her.
So let's go back to that, Attorney Guanzon.
This resolution is so difficult to write because there are the answer of Marcos was only 15 pages and all the facts were admitted. How can it be so difficult to write when De La Torre versus Comelec in 1986 stares you right in your face if you read that case, if you understood it? It's very, very
clear. Attorney Guanzon, let's talk about one of the facts that you're discussing there, the receipts that Marcos Jr. submitted as alleged proof that he indeed paid the fines stemming.
The fact that he showed that his lawyer showed a photocopy of a receipt alleging that they paid already the deficiency taxes for 4 years. And I, in my opinion, I wrote that. In fact, in the hearing, I told them, you have to submit a certified true copy of this. That photocopy, it says there it's payment for lease payments. Even if it's payment for deficiency taxes for those 4 years, it does not cure the defect. That offense involves moral turpitude. Iba naman yan, bata malit will understand that. If you get something from the government, you have to return to the government what it is due. In the Bible, it says, render unto Caesar what is Caesar's, and to God, what is God's. So we have to pay our taxes. How come he gets away with it? Oh, because he's the son of Ferdinand Marcos? Well, with more reason, he should comply with the law because he was the son of the president.
Finally, Attorney Guanzon, there are those who say that the decision puts the May 2022 elections back on track, that this won't now allow for any distractions to happen, that the only way to win the elections really is to win it. What are your thoughts regarding that?
Yeah, that's... Well, there are two things that can happen. Marcos Jr. can lose this election because of his lies. And precisely because of the admissions of his lawyers in COMELEC. The other is he can be disqualified by the Supreme Court, even after he wins or before May 9. Now he's more in danger if he is disqualified before May 9 by the Supreme Court, because then he has to be substituted. If he's substituted by his wife, I was told that the Marcos loyalists will not vote for his wife, but she's not Marcos by bloodline. And that is where his problem is. That's why I keep on telling the Marcos loyalists, it's better if he is disqualified by the Supreme Court. He should be disqualified before May 9, so he can substitute, or he can be substituted. Otherwise, if he's disqualified, let's say on May 10, then he cannot sit. If he's disqualified after he has assumed office, he will still be removed from office. Now, I need you lawyers to pay attention. You study the cases of Makiling and Arnado for our next session here. And you tell me, if he's disqualified by the Supreme Court, did this disqualification occur at the time that he signed the certificate of candidacy? Or did it occur after he signed the certificate of candidacy? Read the Makiling decision and the Arnado cases. All right, that's enough lecture for today. Constantino, and because my puppy is sick, that's why I'm staying home. No?
I appreciate you coming to the show. Former COMELEC. Former COMELEC Commissioner Rowena Guanzon there joining us this afternoon. We appreciate you taking some time out to join us today. Thanks a lot. Cute puppy over there. Take care.